In 1306, Scotland was on the brink of losing their independence to England. A war that had been brutal and unforgiving for many. The Scottish folk wanted freedom. A year prior, in 1305, the Scottish folk hero, William Wallace, was executed in Rob Royston. This led the newly crowned King Robert the Bruce to call out the Scottish clans to seek unity. If we surrender our country, we surrender our spirits. Messages were sent out to all the clans. Many messengers was caught by the English soldiers, and Robert the Bruce was ambushed at the Battle of Methven and deemed an outlaw by King Edward I after he murdered John Cunion. Those clan leaders that remained set up secret meetings between them deep inside the forests to discuss if they should die for their freedom or live for their enslavement. Robert the Bruce called for help for one final stand at the Battle of Bannockburn. At this time, the Scots had gained more territory, but the English would not give up easily. These meetings between the clan leaders is what led the Scottish folk to fight one final time. I will never beg for mercy. I only see freedom.
Let's discuss this matter.
These old knees won't last much longer. So, how you all doing?
Well, what do you think?
Doesn't matter how we are doing,
but rather what we are doing.
What's there to do?
Robert the Bruce and the others has gained more and more land in the Midlands, and he says they're moving the English further out. Make him down to yon last stand.
The only thing Robert the Bruce does is blether oot his arse!
Andrew, keep it down, will ya?
Aye, but at least he fights for his country.
No, he doesn't. The only thing he does is sacrifice his country. I mean, let's not kid ourselves. Isn't it why Wallace is dead?
Andrew, you can. That's not how it got.
I'm getting tired of hearing you blithering about how Robert the Bruce doesn't care about his country. He fights. We fight. Unlike yourself.
Who are you to talk? You've never been in battle.
What are you blithering about? I haven't fighting ever since the English crossed the borders.
Lies! You only fight if they step inside your England.
You keep your waist by there. We know how to fight among ourselves. No over loud.
We should gang along with Bruce and the others. We can bring good men to fight. And if it's true that we've already regained my land, and I believe we can force the English completely out.
Aye. How do you feel about it, Andrew?
Don't I like it. We might be winning on some ground. But do you mind who we was when the first king those years ago? If we fight back, they'll bring mair and mair beasties, till we've all been slaughtered. There's a chance we can bide alive and watch our weans grow. If we don't fight back.
If Robert the Bruce can truly shove the English beasties away, and I heard some of the Irish was helping us, and I believe we can win this. If we unite.
Andrew. I ken what you're thinking. But mind why we had these meetings. Why we hide in secret. We can't keep living as slaves for the English. It's no real.
You ken. Malice is right. You cannae allow yourself to hide in fear.
Ah, don't hide away in fear. Why are you suddenly speaking up about ganging with Robert the Bruce?
Hey, hoot it down, Andrew.
No, I will not. I'm sick and tired about that wee cow. You were the first to go want to get rid of Robert the Bruce, and now you want to join him. You've never walked more than 50 metres outside your own glen. And I tell you, I've been in the battles.
Me and Malice. So, why don't you just keep your mouth shut for once?
My mouth shut?
Aye.
You're the young blithering about surrendering our country to the wee side beasties. Have you heard what they did to old Barrack's daughter and wife?
I don't care about old Barrack's. He probably even deserved it. Look, me and my family have never been hurt by them. By the time they walk by, you give them a wee crop and a penny and they're on their way again. Don't fight them. It's worse for yourselves.
Do you even hear yourself? Who are you? I never kenned you to be such a coward. Now you take that back. Before you spew me on our brave folk, oh, I swear, I'll make you.
I love my country. But more than that, I love my folk and my kin.
I will not risk death to all of us so we can follow some heartless, godless murderer as a leader. He is my king and never will be. If you want to shed blood right now, I'll be just as heartless as you.
And you listen to yourselves. Do you hear the words you're yelling out? You're both so wrong. But you're both so eager to be right about something where there is no right or wrong.
Malice.
Listen, Andrew. Listen to what he says. Don't you understand? Don't you see it? I can't believe you can be that blind. You talk about giving them a wee crop and a penny and they'll be on their way. I suppose that's much better than to starve to death, right? At least they didn't put their filthy fingers on your wife or daughter. But how much can you give before you, or your folk, or your family will starve to death? They don't care about you. They don't care about any of us. And Alistair, you're also wrong. You talk with such a loud mouth. It is true. You haven't been in those battles. Yet you're so eager to fight for the freedom of Scotland. But you don't. You watch. You watch while they were raping Melinda. All because you could tell old Barrack's that there's nothing we can do. And then later, you would run your mouth about how next time you see them, you're going to slaughter them all, but you don't. You don't do it. I don't understand any of you. I thought that when Robert the Bruce had called and told that the clans were uniting, I thought that this for the first time was something we could agree on. That fighting for our country, for our folk, came afore our ignorance. But I was wrong. But I'll tell you this. If just the young man from my village decides he no longer wishes to give and give, if just Yin Man tells me he no longer wishes to give his food, his money, his wife, his life, if just Yin Man decides to go to Stirling to unite with Robert the Bruce, irregardless if it's his king or not, then I will walk. I will walk until my legs fall off. Because you weren't there with Wallace. You didn't see what happened. And you can, Alistair. They're just as heartless as yourself pretend to be. Deal with your lives as you wish. Just mind. In the morn, I'll be gone. In a week, you winna ken where I am. In a month, you might never see me again. I'll tell you this, I'm disappointed. But I'll walk away instead.
Malice,
wait.
I hear what you say. I hear the words you say. I look at myself in agony. How have I fallen this far? Do you think I see it? Every day, my folk will give everything they have to them wee little beasties. The only reason I haven't touched my lassie, or daughter, is because I keep giving them mair and mair until they're satisfied. I have no remorse. You're right. But while we talk, I fear. Malice, I fear death. I fear what will become of me. What will become of my kin? What will happen to my country? Ken, it's not right. I can, I do. And you're right, Malice, we have become fools. No longer shall we be tortured this way. If we have to get in our graves, it's better to do it. We fight for something that matters, instead of crawling in here, starving half to death. In honor of God, I will fight for freedom. In honor of God, I will fight for life. In honor of God, I will fight for death. In honor of God, I will fight for Scotland. No more hiding away.
You're right, Malice. I'm sorry, Andrew. I'm not much better myself. It's just, I wish I had the courage to stand against them. But after what I saw when he took Melinda, our ex-wife, and his lassie, I just couldn't. The fear of seeing them harm my boy or my wife. I had done something.
It's never too late to make that choice, Alistair.
No more pretending. No more hiding. In honor of God, I'll fight for freedom. In honor of God, I'll fight for life. In honor of God, I'll fight for death. In honor of God, I'll fight for Scotland.
In honor of God, I'll fight for freedom. In honor of God, I'll fight for life. In honor of God, I'll fight for death. In honor of God, I'll fight for Scotland.
In 1314, Scotland faced the English army led on by King Edward I and held their ground. Under Robert de Bruce, the brave and proud Scots of all colours, of all clans, united that day at the Battle of Bannockburn to fight for their freedom, and in the end, they came out victorious.